Hi there, my name is Dimitris Haralabidis, and in this video, which is actually the fourth part on my sequential series on tree diagrams, we will see one type of exercises based on tree diagrams. In this specific type, it's the case in which we are given a tree diagram and we are asked to find a conditional probability. And here, keep that, bear that in mind, that the key word will be the word given. In this case, when we will be asked to find the probability of, let's say, A happening, given that B has already occurred, in this case, we need to apply the formula that says that probability of A given B is equal to the quotient of probability of A and B over the probability of B. Let's see how it works through one example. Here, you are given a tree diagram. It's, as always in this series of videos, the common example of selecting either the car or bus to go to school and then seeing whether I'm on time or late. And we have also the corresponding probabilities. Now, we want to find the probability of being late given car. This slash notation means the given. Based on the formula we just mentioned in the beginning, this should be equal to probability of late and car over the probability of car. The probability of late and car is the first type of exercise in which we care for a specific road. Late and car is this specific road. So its probability would be 0.2 times 0.3. The probability of car is just the 0.2. So here, by simply simplifying, we would get 0.3. Which is, let us have a small conversation on that, which is something that we should expect. Remember, in the very beginning, in the first video, we mentioned that a tree diagram is a way to visualize a sequence of events, information put in logical order. Here, we have a conditional probability, but look what the logical order is. At first, I'll decide whether I'll use the car or the bus, and then I'll decide whether I'm on time or late. The given part here is the thing that is already the first one in order. So when I am asked to calculate the probability of being late, given that I have used the car, this means that I have already used the car, which means that I am here. So, based on the fact that I am here, I have used the car, what is the probability of being late? Obviously, 0.3. If you cannot consider that, just apply the formula. The formula will always work. But in the case of the given condition being already done, you don't need that necessarily. Let's see where, when things start to become a little bit more hard. It's when the given part is the second in order. For example, find the probability of using the car given that I was late. So you see that although the selection of the car is placed at first, and then the decision on whether I'm late or on time takes place, now the question tries to alter this order because it assumes that the lateness has already occurred. In here, we have to do it simply through the formula, according to which the probability of car given late is equal to the probability of car and late over the probability of late. Probability of car and late is equal to the probability of a specific road. So it's this, 0.2 times 0.3. The probability of late is the probability of a specific outcome. So we need to calculate all roads that lead to late. It could be this and that, or bus and late. Take their probabilities separately, 0.2 times 0.3 and 0.8 times 0.1, and add them. So it should be 0.06 over 0.14. And that would be the answer on that. So once again, to summarize what we saw, remember that in case of conditional probability, always apply the formula. You don't necessarily need it always, as we saw in example one, but it's certain that the formula works always. For any question that might have come in mind after watching this video, please feel free and welcome to leave your comment below. As always, thank you for your time.